everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today is Saturday and I've just finished my ANE block, and today I'm just gonna celebrate and eat out with my friends and Martin. Well, not friends, well, I only have Hakeemah and Martin to come with me. So yeah, let's go. Kasihan ada orang buat footage untuk me outfit OOTD. Lihatkan coffee-nya. Yes. Okay. Silakan. Cuma di belakang aja cesol. First Christmas tree we've. This is the first Christmas tree we've seen here, and Christmas lights. We're just waiting for our bus at this bus stop. Kacamataku yang kabur ataupun camera. What do you think? Let me know in the comment below. Hi everyone, it's so cold. Even when you like talking, there's like a vape coming out. Can you see it? Cute! You are my high. Bye-bye. Hi, everyone. I just went back home from Southside. So we went to Queen's Victoria Park and we had a coffee at Short Long Black, if that's what it's called. I forgot what it's called. And we went for a steak. We went for a dinner at Steak Inn. And I had a large T-bone. It was so expensive, but it's totally worth it. I will definitely recommend to everyone to go there, and it's halal, and I think everyone will agree with me because it's really, really good, and you guys need to try it if you ever come to Glasgow. Well, it's quite far, a wee bit from the city or from my place or from the students' area, but it's fine. Anyway, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna prepare for my talk tomorrow. So I have a talk with BPM FAS, a faculty in UBD. Basically, this talk is going to be touching about mental health and how students are going to cope with the lockdown in Brunei. But I'm just going to give them some tips that I will be using now and before when I was in UBD. I'm going to give them some uni tips on how to study, on how to socialize, on how to talk with the lecturers, as well as... Well, that's basically a wee bit about it. I forgot what else. Yeah. Okay, see you on the other footage. I'm actually really tired. Hi, everyone. So right now, I've just decided to make this video as a reflection about my A&E placement. So I'm right now in my bedroom, by the way. So from my A&E experience as a medical student, I think it's quite alright because I get to expose to varieties of cases that I've never seen before, as well as skills and the procedures that are being done at A&E. It's very rare to see people putting on central line to patients. And also, there are cases like traumatic cases, for example, road traffic accidents and like drug overdose. Those are the things that are usually being done in A&E. However, you rarely see this in other wards because in the wards, the patient might be stable, but they just need to further monitor the patient. So that's why they admitted into the wards. And I actually really love my A&E placement. And I'm really glad to say that because throughout the whole 5 weeks, I'm always afraid that there will be something that makes me not like A&E. But eventually, alhamdulillah, after 5 weeks, I feel like this is the thing that I would want to do in the future. I'm just gonna put it in my basket. Although there are several things that I like as well, like Beats, GP, but I think A&E is the closest thing to my heart since I like how critical thinking, spontaneous decision making, really sticking to guidelines, and really involved with hands-on experience and being on the ground with the consultants all the time. I really love the presentations by the patient who came. Well, yeah, maybe I will need to take A&E for my foundation year so that I get to experience it firsthand to treat these patients. Overall, 5 weeks just flew by so quickly. But when I was in the second week, I already felt so tired because we were told to finish 110 hours. But because of the swaps that I made with some of my friends, and I also went for a sick day leave for 1 day, and that reduced my hour up until 98 hours only. But I will say 98 hours is a lot. It's really a lot. And most of my shifts are back shift. So we have three shifts. Basically, for the morning shift, it will start at 8 and finish at 4. The back shift will start at 4 and finish at 10 at night. And the weekend shift, it will start at 10 p.m. and will finish at 8 a.m. in the morning. And I did one weekend shift in my first week, if I'm not mistaken. And I have lots of back shifts, maybe about 8. Yeah, I have 8 back shifts all over. And I have, the rest were just like day shifts. But day shifts, I would consider it's quite long because it's 8 to 4. So at A&E as well, we have 3 different tier. Firstly is resus. Resus is where most of the patients are very ill. And then second one would be major. And the third one, no. Second one is HD, high dependency. And the third one is major. And the last one would be minor. And minor injury is only occupied by the nurses who are dealing with patients. And they are also able to treat the patients the same as the doctor does. From this experiences from each one of these departments, from each different tiers, I really like resus, and most of my friends don't really like it, but I consider resus is the place where I learn the most. In fact, NE placement is the only block that I think I learned the most from the placement itself. I just go back home to relax and sleep or eat even. Yeah, I guess I really like being on the ground and studying on the ground instead of doing something else at home. I'm not sure. But let's see how it goes in the future, what I will like. So far, I just really love A&E. So that's just my thoughts. 5 minutes. Bye. Hi, everyone. Currently, it's only 6:36 in the morning. I woke up so early for a BPM fast talk, and it's about fixed mindset, growth mindset. But mostly, I'm going to talk. Well, I've told you yesterday. So this is for the Bruneian people. I do this for you. And I just can't say no, although the time difference is a wee bit wonky and weird. And I just need to wake up early for it, but that doesn't matter because I'm free today, I'm free tomorrow, and next week I'm just gonna do some stuffs online, so that's fine. Perhaps I'm gonna go to sleep right after the talk, and I was a bit nervous the past few days because I haven't prepared the slides and all, but now I have it. I think I'm just gonna talk based on my own experience, which will be much more valuable for the people. Yeah, so these are my slides, as you can see here. I'm not sure why my voice is so raspy, and yeah, I'm gonna use Q&A by using mentimeter.com. And this is my slides. It looks quite cute because I'm using a template from Canva. It's easier nowadays. You can just like take a template anywhere else. Yeah, that's basically about it. Good job, BPM Fast. Thank you for inviting me. Yeah.